Good morning students. Today's topic is sectional view. Today we will learn about the sectional view and its purpose and various types of sectional view. First, see the definition. You know there is orthographic views in our drawing. Orthographic views means in such a drawing where projectors are parallel to each other and perpendicular to plane, and we draw front view, top view and side view from the pictorial view of the object. This is orthographic views. And when we draw the orthographic views, we see there are lots of dashed line. This dashed line indicates the hidden edges of that object. Sometimes in a drawing there are lots of dashed line and it is very difficult to imagine the actual object of the drawing. And you see hidden lines sometimes create problem to understand the actual shape of the object. So to overcome this problem, we will learn the sectional view. Sectional view means we cut the object from a point, certain point, and remove a part, and then we draw the sectional view. Sectional view shows the interior details of a object. Now the purpose of the section. Sectional view show the interior details and it replaces the complex orthographic views and describe the materials in a assembly. Now the types of section. Types of section, the first is full section, there is half section, then revolved section, then removed section, offset section and partial section. So we will learn today about all of the sectional views. First we will see the full sectional view. Full sectional view is drawn through the entire length of the object. This is the cutting plane line and this arrowhead indicates the from where we visualize the object, and see the cutting plane we have drawn from first to last, that cuts the total length of the object. And after then we have drawn in the hatch line in the sectional part, and here it is given the section AA. It means this cutting plane line indicates the section line AA. Suppose there is an example. This is the object, actual object, and before section we draw the front view and top view of this object, and see there are lots of dashed line in this object. Now there is a plane, is yellow color plane. This cutting plane line cuts the object into two part, and the first part is removed, and then you visualize the object from this side, and then you will get this sectional view. See, there is no hidden line or dashed line in this view, only just sectional line, hatch line I have drawn, and this dashed line has been omitted in the sectional view. This is your full section. There is another example. See, there is a cylindrical object in the example 3, and in the front view we cannot understand what is the interior details of this object. After cutting this section plane, and if we remove the first part, front face, and then we will get this type of object. This is your top view and this is your front view. See, there is another example. This object is divided into two parts, and after removing the left side part we will get this type of figure, and this hatch line indicates that object has been section. Now it is half section. Half sections means the line divides the object into section portion and non-section portion, and the cutting plane cuts the object the half length or the width. The half length means the this circle is total length is diameter, shows the diameter, and this section line indicates the half section, because this section line have drawn in half portion of this object. This is full length and this is half length. Radius is half length, so section line has drawn half length. And see, there is hatch line indicates the object has been section in half portion, and there is no section line in this part, in the left side part, so there is dotted line indicates that this part has not sectioned, only the right side part has been sectioned. There is another example of half section. See, this is the total object and there is two planes. This is 1/4 of this object has been removed and 3/4 is remaining. After removing 1/4 part, we will get this is the front view, the section portion. Before section, this is the front view of this object. There is dashed line in the full object, and after removing the 1/4 part, we will get this half sectional view. And see, hatch line is drawn half part of this object. Now is revolved section. In the revolved section, there is a section plane. We will draw the section plane is perpendicular to the axis of the object, and after section, the sectional view is drawn on the object, on the section plane. And removed section is same type of revolved section. The only difference is that in the removed section, sectional view is drawn outside of the object and is located somewhere else in the drawing, but not in the section plane. See, there is a comparison. You see this figure. For the revolved section, if you see, we have sectioned this object in two part. This portion, for this portion, we will get a circular object, and for this portion, we have section and we will get a hexagon. This circle and a hexagon are drawn of the same object. This is the sectional view, and this is also sectional view. Both the sectional view has drawn on the surface of the object. But in the removed section, you see, we will get same type of section view, but this sectional view has drawn outside of the object, not in the object. You can draw this view in the below of the object or anywhere, but not in the object. Next is offset section. Offset section is combination of two or three or more than any plane, and all the planes are at 90 degree. This is a object, and there is sectional plane. There is one section, second sectional plane, third and fourth. This is combination of four section plane we have drawn. You see, this is the offset section. All these offset line are at 90 degree with each other. Next is partial section. Partial section is drawn on the small portion of the object. This is the total object, and we have drawn only the section on the little bit portion, and no need to the hatch line on the full object. You see, I have drawn the section line on the small portion, and the hatch line indicates only this portion. No need to draw hatch line in the full object. This is the partial section. Partial section sometimes is called broken out section. This is all your sectional view. See, this is your problem sheet of sectional view, and I have drawn this problem in A4 page. First of all, I have drawn margin in outside 10 mm gap from the outside margin. Then I have drawn this figure of full section. See, I have drawn this square 40 mm side, and the height is also 40. You can take any length of this drawing. You can take 40, 50, 20, any length, but is no need to give the dimension in the drawing in conventional representation. The first, see, this is full sectional view I have drawn. There is sectional line I have drawn. This is drawn from entire length from first to last, and after then I have drawn hatch line of the in the front view. Front view will be in the front view we will draw hatch line, but in the top view there is no need to draw the hatch line. There will be in the top view only the sectional line, the cutting plane line, this is also called. Then I have drawn this revolved section. There is two example is given of revolved section. One is flywheel and second is crane hook. You can draw any one. I have drawn flywheel drawing. This is conventional representation of revolved section. You can take any dimension or diameter of this length. Then see the removed section. This is the pictorial view of the removed section. If you cut this object at the point C, you will get this type of figure in the front view. And if you cut the object at the point C, you will get this section BB. And if you cut at the point A, this is the point A. If you cut at point A, you will get this type of figure at section A. Here you see there is written point A is this, that point, this is midpoint is B, and this point is C. And this is the sectional front view, and this is the top view. And this is the drawing of taper block, and this is called removed section. So I have drawn this figure. You can take any length of this drawing. Next is your partial section. This is the partial section. After drawing the orthographic view of this object, you draw this irregular line. You draw this line in free hand of any shape. After then you draw the hatch line of this portion at 45 degree angle and 2 to 3 millimeter gap. See, I have drawn this line, this irregular shape. This line indicates the hatch line is needed only this portion. No need to draw the hatch line, the full object. This is the advantage of partial section. Partial section is done only for small part of the object. Next is your offset section. This is the drawing of offset section. There is two example. This is first example and this one is second example. I have drawn the first example in the A4 page. So in the offset section there is more than two or three cutting plane lines. See, there is one horizontal cutting plane line AB, then another cutting plane line BC, then another cutting plane line CD. All these lines are at 90 degree with each other. If we draw this section plane line at horizontally in a single line, then these two circles will not intersect. So there is a metallic plate in this drawing. In metallic plate there is one taper hole, this one is taper hole, and there is another hole, this is counter bore hole. And if you draw the section line from A to D in a single horizontal line, then only one taper hole is visible and another one is not visible. That's why I have drawn this section plane line at 90 degree with each other. And after then you hatch this portion at same 45 degree angle and 2 to 3 millimeter gap. This is offset section. Next is your half section. This is your half section drawing. There is concentric circle, three concentric circle, in the top view, and in the front view there is a block, and I have drawn the section plane line XY, and this line is 90 degree with each other. There is two section plane line, first is XO and then O2Y. This combination of two section plane line is drawn entire half length of the object. This is the total length of the object, and the half length means only this portion. So the section plane line in the half section, I have drawn half portion, only 3/4 part is remaining, and 1/4 part after removing you will get this half sectional view. You see there is drawn the without dimension I have drawing. There is cutting plane line, there is you must indicate this arrowhead in this direction, and this is your half sectional view. Now start the conventional representation chapter. So you have to draw these diagrams in your A4 page. So first you take a A4 page and draw the margin, the fourth side, taking 10 mm gap or 1 centimeter gap in fourth side. So see, first you take a point from the edge 10 mm, then you take another point of 1 centimeter or 10 mm. Now you join these two lines. So this is the margin of A4 page. Now you have to draw the horizontal and vertical line with the help of this margin. So first I'm drawing this figure, sectioning conventional for shaft, pipe, bar and wood. So first is metal rod. This is the front view of metal rod, and this one is the side view. So first draw the center line. The center line should be horizontal. So this is the margin, and you taking with the help of this margin you draw horizontal line. This edge and this line will meet in a same line. Now with the help of this line you draw the center line first. In this way you can draw vertical line also. This is your margin, and you match this edge with this line and draw the vertical line. Now all these angles are 90 degree. Then you draw the side view. This point is center, and taking any radius you draw a circle. Now draw this vertical line. And through this point you draw horizontal line. Similarly, for the above point, you also draw now. This is a break line. This indicates the length of the shaft is
very large and we have taken the small length. So there is this type of these two section line in opposite direction. So I have drawn this in below. Now we have to draw the above portion. Now we have to draw the hatch line. For the hatch line, you use this set square. All these lines are 45 degree angle and 2 to 3 millimeter gap. So this is the conventional representation of a metal bar. This is front view and this one is side view. In the same way, you draw metal tube, metal bar and wood one by one. See, this is your drawing of sectioning convention of shaft pipe and bar and wood. I have drawn all these drawings here. First one is metal rod, second one metal tube, then metal bar and then wood. You have to draw this all four drawing in a single page.